Hello, beautiful souls. It's Mary from Psychic Soulmate. This video is a three-card tarot reading for our week, February 10th to February 17th. And it doesn't matter even if you're watching this after the date that I just said, because the message and the reading was intended for you because you mysteriously landed here. So you take what you need and you leave what you don't, okay? So the cards I'm working with are the Psychic Tarot by John Holland. I love these cards. I love John Holland's work. I have his books, took a workshop with him. I have to say he's pretty amazing, okay? So I've already dealt and put the cards out, so to save us some time. And the first card that we got is the Eight of Wands, which is positive movement forward. And so this is what we are experiencing right now. There is a lot of shifts going on. So we're getting those highs and those lows. The energy seems very high, but we feel very high. But then sometimes we get really sensitive and we're feeling like really down, like there's something that's causing us some pain. I know you're probably feeling that. It's like, why am I feeling this? Because when change happens, it's pleasant. It's not always the pleasant feeling. It's pleasant to have change. It's good to go through a change once in a while. It's good to change it up and switch it up. You've heard that. And it's like, but sometimes when we're going through the change, it's a little scary and it can cause some fear and it can cause some a little bit of sadness. So you might be feeling those highs and lows with little changes. Now, it could be you're going through the emotional feeling. It doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to change your job and change your house, or you're going to like change your relationship and just like you're going to just move out or something, or there's going to be just a complete overall change. Not that kind of change. I'm talking more like emotional, like we're taking the action, because the Eight of Wands is taking the action. You are taking the action. You are doing something for yourself at the same time, or you need to do something for yourself. If you're not, this is a message for you that you need to take that action to make those changes. And it's okay. No judgment if you're procrastinating or feeling like you're, you know, on the sidelines and not ready to do it. I know I'm there. I'm there. I go through the same challenges myself. You know, sometimes we tend to procrastinate, you know, but it takes 21 days to make a habit intact. And I can go on and on about that, but I'm just going to tell you right now that you are being divinely guided to make that change in your life. And something is happening inside. This is emotional. And so you might be feeling like you're far away from it and you can't have it. Oh, and never say those words. I can never do this. And I hear people say that, oh, that's not for me. How could I do that? That's not for me. I can't do that. Or she or he will never love me. Or I just don't feel lovable. I don't feel like I can have love in my life. So this is when you say those things, you're actually pushing what's in your highest good, what's in there for your highest good. You're actually pushing that away. You're actually pushing away and making it worse for yourself. So stop the negative. That's the one thing. First thing you're going to do is, my advice is to start saying positive things, positive affirmations, unexpected. Try to get yourself out there. You don't have to do this. It's just something that I'm feeling and saying, and this is what I'm seeing. And you take what you need and you leave what you don't. And you might be saying to yourself, well, I'm just not feeling like I need to do this. And maybe this is not meant for me. And okay, I'm just going around in circles saying that because I'm feeling the energy. When I record these videos, I'm feeling the energy of what you're feeling. Even though they're pre-recorded, there's no time when it comes to spirituality. You know that in Spirit Guide. So I'm getting that message really clear that you need to slow down too. I'm getting that message. You need to slow down. So that's why I'm gonna talk a little slower. If it's a message for me, because I get excited. When I get a message, it's like, oh, I just wanna, you know, just give it and just, you know, I get really high energy and excited, you know. And so I love to communicate. It's about communication. So my message to you is to believe in yourself about this and to know and to have the confidence and, you know, put yourself out there, because there's something that's telling you that you need to put yourself out there and not be afraid. And you might be feeling, as far as relationships and love goes, you might be feeling somebody doesn't care about you. You're feeling disconnection from an individual, someone that you really do love, your twin flame, your soulmate, your karmic soul connection with someone. You're feeling that disconnection, but that person's actually thinking of you. You know what I mean? Like, so it doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to be communicating with them, but you need to do things for yourself in order for your beloved, for your significant other, whatever you want to call it. Okay, I don't want to label it as a such, because I'm just trying to say let's just say your divine partner wants you, their higher self wants you to do things for yourself that love yourself and get out there and to do these things. And the first thing you got to do is you got to know and trust, love yourself. That's the first thing I'm going to say. Just do that, okay? The second card is the Two of Wands, which is the waiting game. And that the waiting game is just waiting for it to happen. As you can see, it's a spiral. You have to spiral yourself upward. But also, you're waiting for something. You're waiting for a sign. You're waiting for a message. Your sign is coming. This is your sign right now. The sign is telling you that you need to stop waiting, stop worrying, and just get yourself and just pick up your feet and just start walking. You know, start doing what you need to do to take those actions into getting yourself up off the couch or off the chair and just start moving. Start moving yourself. Wands are action-based. And when you are connected to your truth, you can actually feel more revived and more alive and just more happier, right? And you can connect with your significant other on the other side. You know, when I say the other side, I mean like, you know, your divine partner on the other side. Or maybe you haven't met your divine partner yet, but you can connect. You know, I can tell you stories about Dave and I, how we connected before we even got together, and like how we were doing things spiritually and telepathically, but we knew he was out there. I knew he was out there and he knew I was out there. We didn't stress over it, but we just knew that we were out there. So we took the actions, and it's so amazing how it happened, because we had a full moon meditation that we used to go to in the area. We live in the same area. And we would just pass each other by, like two ships in the night, you can say. We didn't even see each other. And yoga class, I'm just going to go on. It's not about me and Dave, but I'm just going to tell you right now, it's important that you take those action steps, because before you know it, you're going to, bam, you're going to bump into your twin flame and your divine partner, and you're going to find that love, or that person's going to finally, like, you're going to meet somebody that, like, your divine partner that you've been separated for a while is going to, the universe will bring you together. But you need to take steps now and stop waiting. That's what I say. You got to stop waiting. Okay. And also, when it relates to business, you know what? It all starts, you can have anything your heart desires if only you are aligned to that truth center. So everything that I apply this to relationships, because I feel a lot of love is, we're asking about love right now, because love is this part of the month, the part of the year, we tend to look at love, because it's Valentine's Day coming up soon. When you're watching this, when I post it, it's just right around the corner. So we kind of feel that love vibe, right? We just feel, you know, we're missing that person. And so, you know, it relates to a lot of things when we're not connected to our soul, because we should love ourselves. When you love yourself, you actually attract that person, your divine partner, into your life. When you are loving yourself, when you are divine, you know, feeling a divine light, because your divine partner is just a mirror to you of what you are experiencing to yourself. And not everybody can do that, can be that mirror to you. Okay, I'm reading that mirror to you. I'm not showing you the mirror, I'm actually reading it to you. So your divine partner will actually mirror that to you. So that's how you feel all those love vibes, right? And because you are connected to your soul, okay? And so now the third card is truth. So this is being in your truth. So actually, we are coming into our truth. 2020, oh, look at, that's a 20. Honestly, yes, I did not plan for that. I did not. So 2020 is like the best time for us to experience love. It may be just a time in our life right now that might be a feel like it's a, you know, like there's a little bit of things that are stagnate. Things are just at a crossroads, or things that just seem like they're very slow moving. Like I talked about in my previous video, if you watched the last one from this, okay? And it's like everything seems to be going really slowly, but it's not. It's actually going to pick up. Things are going to start to pick up. Because why? Because we've experienced all of these things. We've actually faced our shadow. We've been looking at our shadow. We've been looking at all the things that we don't want to look at. And sometimes when you don't want to look at it, guess what? It shows you. Fears. We are faced with our shadow, because the shadow needs to, you need to see that and then release it and then move on. You know, that's the only way you can let go and release and then attract abundance to you. So this is telling you that your truth, what you're looking for and what you're searching for, you are going to find it. But you need to believe in you. You need to believe in yourself. You need to take that action. You need to do and serve, and whatever it is, you know what that is, and whatever comes to your mind, just get inspired, okay? I'm just gonna say one thing, just get inspired. Let my energy flow to you to inspire. I'm wearing red, and red just, you know what, colors do things to me. That's why I like to make my, I've been not procrastinating on the tarot course. I am working on that tarot course as we speak, but I wanted to make it Very perfect. So I am a little bit of a perfectionist. So yeah, it's coming soon. A tarot course for beginners to advanced students. It's for everybody. It's my old technique ways that I've been reading. Anyways, I'm not here to sell you on that, but I'm just telling you a little something what their cards are saying. So it's a, everything is happening in divine timing. So colors mean everything. So I have been working with colors a lot, and I want it to be like the right color when you're watching it and you're feeling that, because color therapy is a big thing. It's a healing thing. So wear those colors, you know, wear red to be vibrant, even if you don't see it, even if it's just something just tickling my eyes for some reason, or something that is like, that's just going to bring you out. Or buy yourself some flowers, buy yourself some colored flowers, just get out there. You know what? And don't think about it. You know, the more you think about it, the more you're going to turn yourself around to the other direction. So I advise you to just play and just to have fun with it. Have fun with life. Okay, that's my message to you. And I hope that this reading was helpful for you. And if you're interested in getting a longer reading, visit my website, psychicsoulmatereading.com. Until the next video, I wish you all peace, blessings, love, and light to you all. Namaste.